lovely Wednesday here in Scoop and Scoop, and I thought I was going to talk about something, but then it skipped my mind because I saw worse stuff happening. Down to me believing that certain artists, when you take a hiatus, and when you do take that hiatus, it wasn't self-imposed. The industry rejected you and threw you away. They chewed you out like cat and then threw you very far. Buchaman, what is Buchaman still doing in this industry? Down to him and Palazzo thinking they could revive someone's career. Yeah, there's a lot that's happening. Not forgetting the BET scandals that was happening. Of course, Anita Fabiola is mixed in there somehow. There's Diamond Platinums. Ladies and gentlemen, there's a lot that is happening. My name is Tina and welcome to the Wednesday edition of Scoop and Scoop. So, I got wind of a story that made me go like, banange. Palazzo and Buchaman apparently are doing a song together. Now I'm sitting there and I'm like, hold up. Palazzo, according to me, is a very huge struggling artist. And when I say struggling, literally, onogaya imba nori imba nabagamba twatoba. Ya chatoba. Now there is Buchaman on the other hand. I don't know, what was Buchaman's deal? What happened to him and Firebase? Like, he was fire. They robbed money off him. The last time I heard it was something like, Bobby Wine was making a lot of money and he wasn't getting as much as Bobby Wine was, and yet he was in the gang or the crew or whatever. So I'm sitting there and I'm like, I'm not going to do a story about this in full depth because I just want for you to sit down, let it sink in, bring it all in and think about a song. How do you think this song is going to sound? Because they're in studio right about now. I got it exclusively and I'm sitting there like, let me hold my tongue. I'm not going to say anything about it. Let me know, what do you think? I sat down and I thought about it, because as remembering Buchaman in his heydays, when things were going right for him. So I remembered, hold on, Buchaman used to be like Bobby Wine's right hand and left hand. He was that guy when they would set the fire best, you'd know he would be up in your face like there. Then I thought about it, he was fired, he left on very bad terms. But Nubian Lee came in, and Nubian Lee has worked very effortlessly and flawlessly with Bobby Wine. So I asked, what were the dynamics? What made it work with Nubian Lee and Bobby Wine? And what failed with Buchaman and Bobby Wine? Then someone was like, you just need to understand. In this world, it's not all about just location. It's about location and survival in your location. So this is what happened. Buchaman wanted to be the guy who was at the forefront with Bobby Wine. When Bobby Wine is going to sign a UN deal, he also wanted to be putting his signature there. Yes, Bobby Wine and me are in this together. Nubian Lee on the other end was like, look here, boss. I don't want to be like you. I don't mind being the guy who will bring you a bag of weed, get you the cheeks, back you up in your songs once in a while. You give me a commission here and there. Put me in your studio. I'll get to drive fancy cars, be known to be in a certain crew. He was down with that. Buchaman on the other end was like, no, we're in this ish together. So me and you most definitely have to be working on this. So I sat there and I'm like, who signed the bigger deal? Who was much, much better? Was it Nubian Lee or Buchaman who decided, you know what, I am not going to sell myself short. I am out of this place. Or the guy who was like, it's all right, I can take this while lying down comfortably. Then someone said, it is Nubian Lee, of course. I think none of them signed a better deal. Because if Nubian Lee took the time off and decided to grow himself as an individual artist, I think he wouldn't go that far, but he would get someplace. Buchaman on the other end, why he signed a deal that just doesn't make sense to me. He quit because of his pride. He wanted glory, he wanted fame. Quit. The whole world knew about why he was quitting. Everyone was like, Bobby Wine, I name PCMB. But the guy is grassing. The guy has nest. The guy has cried. He has been at Kampala City Festivals like forever. He is back. I don't think you would you invite Buchaman to do a birthday gig for you? No. So Desire Lucinda came out and she said the reason as to why she released her Echitone song stroke video is because, one, Moza Radio told her that it was the best time to release it because then she was going through her nude saga and the sex tape saga. So he told her, according to her, this is what she said, word for word, verbatim, he told me to release the song because it would make me a lot of money at the time. So I sat there and I was like, one, Desire Lucinda, did you ask yourself in what state of mind Radio was in at that particular moment when he was telling you something like that? Like, a guy could have been stoned beyond words, like majorly stoned beyond words. Words is actually an understatement. But you didn't pay that any attention. So someone told me, but there's nothing wrong with that. It did make her money. And I was like, what money? Do you know the reason why that song sold? And the reason why we watched the video? Okay, I personally have never even watched the video of Chitone. Has anyone? It has a video, right?
Yes.
What does she do in the video?
Dancing
at Chitone. Hamnomo usually dances. And then she touches, she turns around, shows us her skinny black legs. That's what she does? Oh, okay. Anyway, I've not watched the video, but I've heard the audio. But then I talked to a couple of men out there, and these are very opinionated, very free-thinking liberal men in UG. They are like, look here, Tina, let's not get this twisted. The only reason why we watched that video, rather the song, the only reason they actually listened to the song and watched the video, given the time it was given and when it was put out, is because half of the times they would hear the song, the only thing they would get was graphic content in their mind of what was happening on that WhatsApp clip. That's what she called. Does anyone have the full clip anyway? No, but like we need, because that was just a clip. I even never got to see her face. Yes, I watched it. Duh, I'm Ugandan. So half of the time we hear the song, every guy sits back and they're like, let me go back to WhatsApp. That clip they sent me of Desiree Dzinda doing her thing. And they were very excited by that sheer fact. Because, yeah, well, it was kind of a little bit exciting for men. But here's what the men said. So after watching that, they all decided, we are going to make sure we get a piece of that. So the men in Kampala, all the rich men in Kampala, banged. You are making a lot of money. I don't want you to lie to us that you made money off the song. No, you made money off the fact that everyone thought it was the soundtrack to that WhatsApp video. You know, like the video is going on and in the background there's a Nine Chitone. That is the reason why everyone was watching it and listening to it. So all the men were like, you know what, let's bang this chick and see if what she's saying is the truth. So all the rich men in Kampala banged, the ones in Nigeria banged, the ones in which other country? South Africa, huh? Banana, South Africa. They banged. Chick even had to go on a little bit of a vacay holiday. I think when she went for that BBC interview too, she was banged by someone there. So basically you were banged for that song. Hashtag, you made a lot of money. But you kind of remind me of a jerrycan. You see, a jerrycan, you pour water in it. When you need the water, use it and put the jerrycan back there. Next time you remember, like, bananga maziga jagenda, you refill the jerrycan, put it there. That's what you are, according to me. I can't say that you're useless, because you're not. You're somebody's mother. You are... I can't call her budding artist. Is this just an artist? Okay, she's an artist at what it is that she does. But I don't want for her to sit there and lie to herself that, oh, that song made me a lot of money. Yes, it made you a lot of money, but not in the light of a musician, no. It made you a lot of money given the fact you were singing it while lying down. And as my living shouts out, big shout out to Radio and Wizzo for actually understanding that your big-headedness won't take you anywhere. There's someone who can calm you down. Jeff Chua, calm these boys down. I think if it was a photo meme, you'd see Radio and Wizzo kneeling down and Jeff Chua would be standing there, hands akimbo like, Nabagambachi. They have finally decided to settle all of this out of court and I'm sitting there like, will these guys ever come back from this? Like, will they ever stand up at any concert and they're like, oh, you're Jeff Chiwa, Tatu Manira, because you'll be seated in the front seat like, what are you saying? Mbazeyo, Mbazeyo, and they're like, no, daddy, to son you. I love this country. My name is Tina. It's been a beautiful time. Don't forget the Twitter handle to follow me at is at TinaFierce1. Or you can go to the Facebook page that is Urban TV or the Scoop and Scoop Facebook page. For now, it's been my time. I'm out. Catch me 5 p.m., 9 p.m. I'm out. Peace.